Hyperlinks DRC in VX 2.5 brings 8 new rules out of the box. Two of these new rules are available in the developer edition, and they are silk clearance and solder mask clearance in the safety section of the rules. There is a minimum clearance distance defined by the layout specifications, and these rules simply check the spacing. In the EMI category, we've added component alignment. Spike currents induced to connectors need to be redirected to ground by ESD components. Depending upon placement, when a circuit is close enough to receive crosstalk from noisy nets, this can cause system trouble. So make sure to align ESD components connected to an I/O component. Another rule that's added to the power integrity category is the stitching via spacing. A plane will resonate to particular frequency signals, so stitching the plane with vias to suppress these resonances is a good idea. There's a minimum spacing requirement for them to be effective, and this rule will check that. The reference plane rule will check a high-speed net that always needs to couple with the correct reference plane. So if a high-speed net is not grounded properly or doesn't have a great return path, this rule will check for that. In this case, this clock signal should be referenced to ground one layer above or below this signal net, but you can see it's 4 layers away on signal 9 from signal 5. If you're using Hyperlinks DRC to verify a layout that wasn't done in-house, you may like the new net length rule to check pin-to-pin lengths and the new trace width rule to check the width of various traces to make sure they are meeting their requirements. Nets routed in parallel on the same layer or even on different layers may couple and cause crosstalk. The vertical parallel routing rule removes the need for manual inspection and checks for target nets that are susceptible to the signal integrity issue.